Hello dear friends, this is a practice question for civil service examination and other all degree level examination. Consider the following statement with respect to invest India. The question is about to invest India. There is a 2-3 statement. Find out which of the statement given above are correct. First one, it was established as a non-profit vendor to promote foreign investment in India. It was established a non-profit vendor to promote the foreign investment in India. Second one, it is a function under the administrative control of Ministry of Commerce and Industry. Third one, the central government owned 51% of the shares in Invest India. The third statement is wrong. The central government and the state government own 49% of the shares in Invest India. So the statement 3 is wrong. 1 and 2 is correct one. It was established as a non-profit vendors to promote foreign investment in India. The second one is, it is a function under the administrative control of the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. So the statement 1 and 2 is the correct. A option is correct. What is Invest India? Invest India is the National Investment Promotion and Facilitation Agency of India and acts as a first point of reference for investors in India. Invest India was formed in 2009 under the section of 25 of the Companies Act 1956 for the promotion of foreign investment. It was established as a non-profit vendor. It is a function under the Department of Industrial Policy and Promotion and the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. The shareholding pattern of Invest India is that 51% of industry association, that is 70% of FICCI and CIA and NASCOM, and remaining 49% is central government and 19 state governments. As a national investment promotion and facilitation agency, Invest India focus on the sector specific investor target and development of a new partnership to sustainable investment in India. In addition to a core team that focus on sustainable investment, Invest in India also partners with the sustainable investment promotion agencies and a multilateral organization. In November 2020, UNDP and Invest India launched a sustainable development goal, Investors Map for India. It's lying out to 18 investment opportunity areas and 6 critical sustainable development enabling sector that can help India push on needles forward for sustainable development. Next question. Siddhanta Shiromani is a major treatise on mathematics. What was authorized by Brahmagupta, Mahavirajarya, Narayan Pandit and Bhaskaracharya? The answer is RD option, Bhaskaracharya. Siddhanta Shiromani is a major treatise on mathematics, was authored by Bhaskaracharya. Bhaskaracharya is one of the prominent Indian mathematician of the 12th century and astronomer who has wrote the book Siddhanta Shiromani. The book is divided into 4 sections. First one, Leelavati. Leelavati is dealing with the arithmetics. And next one, Bijagadita is dealing with algebra. Next one, Goladhyaya, that's dealing with the sphere. And next one, Graha Gandha, that is the mathematics of planets. About Bhaskaracharya, Bhaskara was one of the many outstanding mathematics hailing from South India. He is born 114 CE in Karnataka. He has composed 4 part of text entitled to the Siddhanta Shiromani. Is included this compilation of Bijagandita, which became a standard algebra textbook in Sanskrit. It contained description of advanced mathematical technique involving both positive and negative integers as well as zero irrational numbers. It is traced at length of pulverizer method of solving indeterminate equation and continued fractions as well as the so-called Pell equation dealing with the indeterminate equation of second degree. He also wrote a solution to numerous kind of linear and quadratic equation, including those involving the multiple unknown and equations involving the product of different unknown. And he wrote a highly sophisticated mathematical text that preceded by several centuries the development of such technique in Europe, through in which better term this rediscovery since much of the Renaissance advancement of the mathematics in Europe was based upon the discovery of Arab mathematical text, which was turned highly influenced by the Indian traditions. Next one, next question. Consider the following statement with respect to Chunauti program, a recently launched by Union Government. Which of the statement given above are correct? There is two statement. First one, it was launched by Minister of Commerce and Industry. Second one is aimed to further boost startup and software product, especially in Indian Tier 2 towns. First statement is wrong. Minister of Commerce and Industry. Second statement is correct. It is aimed to further boost startup and software product, especially in the Tier 2 towns. So B is the option. Chunauti. The next generation incubation scheme is a comprehensive incubation scheme with a vision of drive rise of India as a software product. Next generation startup challenge contest, that is Chunauti, is a challenge under the NGIS for advanced and inhibited technology intervention. It's an online challenge under the NGIS further boost startup and software product with a special focus on Tier 2 towns. The program was launched by the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. The government has earmarked a budget 93.03 crore for this period of 3 years for this program. The aim of this identify the 300 startups working in identified areas and provide them a seed fund up to 25 lakhs and other facilities. The startup selected through the Chunauti will be provided various support from the government through the Software Technology Park in India, centers across India. They will be get incubation facilities, mentorship, security testing facilities, access to vendor capitalist fund, industry connect, as well as advisories in legal and human resource and IPR and patent matters. Next question, with reference to the Ahar Granthi mission, consider the following statement. The mission has been launched to create awareness of use of iodized salt is wrong. It has been launched by Ministry of Food Processing collaboration with the Vijnana Bharati, and this movement will work applying Ayurveda based nutrition knowledge practice. Three is the only correct statement. Is the movement will work on applying Ayurveda based nutrition knowledge to practice. The A option is the correct one. Vijnana Bharati, that is VIBA, is a global and a global Indian scientist and a technologist forum, GIST, have come together to launch a mission that's called Ahar Granthi with the motto of the good diet, good cognition. The Ahar Granthi, the movement, are designed to address the peculiar problem being faced in India and the world is called hunger and disease in abundance. The movement is proposed to address the current situation of hunger in abundance by working to raise the people to the value of India traditional diet, to the healing powers of local fruits and vegetables, and to be miracle and balanced diet. It will be renew a focus on nutritionally balanced diets. The program will focus on training teachers who it turn will pass on the message to the multitudinous of students and through this student them to the their families and finally in their society and large level. Such strategy strategy was adopted to eradication of the polio. Such strategy also we are used adopted in eradication of polio and turned to be a grand success. The term objectives, it will be seek to promote better awareness, a better nutrition, better agriculture, and the message will be important through the curriculum in the form of what and why of nutrition to the form of a games or the instructions such as how to and the contest will be provided both online and offline and will be vernacular language besides English and Hindi to reach out many possible reach out as much as possible. Knowledge of Ayurveda based nutrition practice. The movement will work on this too. GIST is an autonomous platform created by Vijnana Bharati. GIST is an autonomous platform created by Vijnana Bharati to link global Indians with under the privileges masses in the country, mostly residing in more than 3 lakh village. GIST was officially launched by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam on 26 December 2010. Consider the following statement with the respect to the Surya Shukrayan missions of India. Consider the following statement with the respect to the Shukrayan missions of India. Which of the statement given above are correct? That is the question. First one, Shukrayan will be the first ISRO mission to Venus and will be map phosphine gas an important biomarker of Venus atmosphere. The two statements are correct. The option is C. The Shukrayan will be the ISRO first mission to Venus and will be map phosphine gas an important biomarker in a Venus atmosphere. India plan to launch a new orbiter to Venus in 2024. Shukrayan orbital will be the first mission to Venus by the India Space Research Organization and will study on planet for 4 years. It is actually launched in a vehicle that is in GSLV Mark III rocket, and a French space agency announced it would be also fly an instrument on Shukrayan. The Venus infrared atmospheric gases linger, that is viral Venus infrared atmospheric gases linger, is a collaboration with the Russian Federal Space Agency Roscosmos for the purpose. Phosphine, a toxic gas made up of the phosphorus and 3 hydrogen atoms, is commonly produced by organic life forms, but otherwise is difficult to make on rocky planet. Was discovered in the middle layer of the Venus atmosphere. The phosphine was discovered in the middle layer of the Venus atmosphere. Phosphine is one of the toxic gas made up of phosphorus and 3 hydrogen atom. It is commonly produced with the organic life form but otherwise difficult to make rocky planet. So only the reason is why India is taking this mission. Another question, consider the following pairs, minerals and world region. First, here is one of the question, iron, Mesabi region rich of iron, Kinda Valley, copper, high yield gold, Chuggi Kamata in Tinna. So the given above are correct one. A is the correct one. 1 and 3 is the correct one. Mesabi region is iron rich iron. Chuggi Kamata is a tin. Mesabi range one of the largest iron ranges in northern Minnesota in the US. It is the largest 4 major iron ranges in the region, collectively known as the Iron Range of Minnesota. Highveld is about half of the gold overproduced in the world being mined in the Highveld, South Africa in since 1980. The largest deposits are located in the Witwatersrand strand, which is center of Johannesburg, with a smaller deposit in the northern Free States near Welcon and Virginia. The gold in this base occur in the coarse grained conglomerates form the upper position of the Witwatersrand supergroup. The host roughly 7,000 meters of sedimentation. Next one, Kindle Valley. Kindle Valley. Kindle Valley is a Perak, Malaysia, has historically as the most productive tin producing district in the world, and the valley is moved in the Kindawar, tributary of Sungai Perak, which is the flow between the main range and Kledang range. It is a form a largest field along the Simas Malaysian Peninsula tin belt. Another one, Chuki Kemeja, is one of the largest open pit copper mines, and is the second deepest open pit mine in the world. Is located in the 1,650 kilometers of Santiago, Chile. The mine, popularly known as Chuki, has been operating since 1910. Chuki Kemeja is one of the openest copper mine. World's relatively poor copper ore is mined impressively huge amount. The important features of this Chuki Kemeja is open cast copper mine. World's relative poor copper ore is mined an impressive huge amount. Mesambi region is rich iron and High Weald is rich gold, Kendah Valley is rich tin, and Chuki Kemeja is rich copper. Consider the following statement: litmus, red cabbage, onion, and turmeric. Which of the above can be used to indicate the presence of acid or basic solution in a solution? That is, litmus, red cabbage, onion, turmeric, all are used for indicator for presence of find out in the presence of acid or base in a solution. Acid are the substance with the particular chemical properties that include that turning litmus to red and neutralizing alkalis and dissolving the sum of the metal. An acid can donate a high and express ions and can remain energetically favorable after the loss of H plus ion. They have pH value is less than 7. In the case of bases, it's a substance able to accept hydrogen ion from an acid. They can donate an hydroxide ions in the solution. That turn red litmus into blue, they have pH values greater than 7. A special type of substance that are used to test whether the substance is acidic or basic. The substances are called indicators. The litmus is a natural indicator, and turmeric also another natural indicator. There are many other natural indicators. Materials are that is red cabbage leaves, colored petals of some flowers such as hydrangea and petunia and geranium, that are indicated of presence of acid or basic in a solution. This is called acid-base indicator or sometimes simply indicators. But another one is olfactory indicators. There are substance change their smell when if mixed with an acid or base. For example, onion, vanilla and clove. That is all olfactory indicators. Next question, with reference to the delimitation, consider the following statement. Here is two statements. Which of the statement given above are correct? That is the question. The first statement, the presence of delimitations of parliamentary constituency has been done on the basis of 2011 census, a figure by 87th Amendment Act. Is absolutely correct. The present delimitation of the parliamentary constituency has been done on the basis of 2001 census, figure by 87th Amendment Act. The second one, the parliament is empowered to determine the authority and manner in which delimitations to be made. and to be delimitation to be made. Which refers to the delimitations? Consider the following statement. The constant is asked about the delimitations. Consider the following statement. The first one, the present delimitations of parliamentary constituency has been done on the basis of 2001 census figure by 87th Amendment Act. Is absolutely correct. Is basis on the 2001 census by an 87th Amendment Act. And this parliament is to be empowered to determine the authority in the manner in which delimitations to be made. The both statements are correct. The option is C. What is delimitation? Delimitation literally means that an act or process of fixing limit or boundaries of territorial constituency in the country and province having a legislative body. The job of delimitation is assigned to high power body such as the body is known as delimitation commission or the boundary commission. In such delimitations commission have been constituted four times, 1952 and 1962 and 1972 and 2002. The 42nd Amendment Act of 1976 has froze the allocation of the seat in the Lok Sabha to the states and the division of each state into territorial constituency till the year 2000 at the 1971 level. The ban on the readjustment was extended for another 25 years up to the 2026 by the 84th Amendment Act of 2001 with the same objective of encouraging the population limitation measures. The 84th Amendment Act of 2001 also empowered the government to undertake the readjustment and rationalization of territorial constituency in the state on the basis of population figure of the 1991 census. Later, the 87th Amendment Act of 2003 had to provide delimitations of constituency on the basis of the 2011 census, ignored by 1991 census. After the every census, the readjustment to be made, that is allocation of seat in the Lok Sabha to the state and the division of each state into territorial constituency, and parliament is empowered to determine the authority and manner in which to be made. Accordingly, the parliament has enacted a delimitation commission act in 1952 and 1962 and 1972 and 2002 for this purpose. Next question. Which of the following statements are the correct regarding the National Bank for Financial Infrastructure Development? Which of the statements are correct regarding on the National Bank for Financing Infrastructure Development? It is a statutory institution in the aim for the development of long-term infrastructure financing in India. It can raise money in Indian rupees as well as in the foreign currencies. Third one, it can lend or invest directly or indirectly infrastructure project located entirely or partially in India. Select the correct one using the code. D is option. All the options are correct. It is a statutory institution that aim for the development of long-term infrastructure financing in India. Second one, it can raise money in Indian rupees as well as in the foreign currencies. Third one, it can lend or invest direct or indirectly in infrastructure project located entirely or partially in India. The context of this question is that recently Parliament enacted a National Bank for Financing Infrastructure Development Act 2021, which laid down the foundations for the establishment of statutory institution, that is National Bank for Financing Infrastructure Development, which was announced in the budget speech by Finance Minister as the principal development financial institution for the infrastructure financing. It will have both development as well as financial objective. The development objectives include facilitation of development of market for bonds, loans and derivatives of long-term infrastructure financing. Functions of NBFID is include extending loan advancements for infrastructure projects, taking over and refinancing such existing loans, and attracting investment from private sector investors and institutional investors for infrastructure project, and organizing and facilitating foreign participation in the infrastructure project in a principal development of financial institution for a long-term infrastructure financing. Financial objective will be directly or indirectly lend or invest or attract investors for the infrastructure project located entirely or partially in India. The central government will prescribe the sector to be covered under the infrastructure domain. The NBFID may raise money in the form of loans or otherwise, both in the rupees and foreign currency, or secure money by the issue or sale of various financial instruments, including bonds, debenture. The NBFID may borrow money from central government, Reserve Bank of India, and Scheduled Commercial Bank and Mutual Bank, mutual funds, and multilateral institutions such as World Bank, Asian Development Bank. It have authorized share capital of 1 lakh crore rupees. The share of NBFID may be held central government, multilateral institution, sovereign wealth funds, pension fund, insurance, financial institution, banks, any other institution prescribed by central government. Initially, the central government will own 100% of share of institution, which may be subsequently reduced up to 26%. Next question. In the context of monetary policy of India, which of the following best describe the term curry order? Is first one, area between lower reverse repo rate and the upper ceiling rate of marginal standing facility. This correct one is A option. Area between the lower reverse repo rate and the upper ceiling rate of marginal standing facility. Monetary policy is refers to the monetary instrument under the control of central bank to regulate the magnitude of such as interest rate, money supply, and availability of credit with a view of achieving the ultimate objective of economic policy. Economic policy. The Reserve Bank of India is vested with the responsibility to conduct the monetary policy. This responsibility is explicitly mandated under the Reserve Bank of India Act 1934. This is how the several direct and indirect instruments have used for implementing this monetary policy. There are curry order is one of the monetary instruments that refers to area between the lower reverse repo rate. Area is between lower reverse rate and the upper ceiling rate of the marginal standing facility is the area between lower reverse repo rate and the upper ceiling rate of marginal standing facility rate. Curry order is for a daily movement in the weighted average gold money rate. Other instruments of monetary policy, that is cash reserve ratio, statutory liquidity ratio, repo rate, reverse repo rate, open market operation, and market stabilization scheme, etc., are other the instruments for taking monetary policy.